Good afternoon, everyone. It's Monday, March 20th, and this is the start of weekly vlog 11. Yeah. Well, I'm freaking sore. My neck, my back, and one of my legs. Well, because it's been, you know, warm and cold. Yeah, I slipped on some black ice, and both feet straight up in the air landed on my back, so I'm hurting right now. I'm definitely going to need some meds. So hopefully by the time you guys watch this, I'll be a lot better, but whatever. So now, got word again that damn aircraft isn't coming till Saturday. I'm not working this weekend, but I'll try to go in on the weekend, try to get it landing and maybe taking off, because it's landing on Saturday, leaving on Sunday, back and forth all week. Not that I'm too worried, because I'll be able to catch it probably sometime during the week. So now I'm probably going to go get changed and then go to Home Depot to get like some swivel things for the powder coating booth or whatever. And I still have my plates to validate or get a new sticker for my plates. So I got to do that. Man, I feel beat up. It's probably going to be worse tomorrow morning. So I'll try to let you guys know tomorrow how I feel, because I'll be at work at 5, so if I can get out of bed, I'll let you guys know. Yeah, nothing really planned this week, except maybe the powder coating stuff, so we'll see. So, off to Home Depot I go. Hey, good Tuesday afternoon. I'm done work, and before leaving work, like the three guys that actually work, three guys that actually work. We all work, but I mean, we're only three guys at work. So the three guys had a meeting with our boss about the solution coming in. It's kind of weird, but like, you know, I saw on the calendar and stuff like that. But when you say it out loud, we're going to be busy with this 21 days, like every day fueling them. And it's about going to be about 35,000 liters a day, stuff like that. And then receiving our fuel loads, and yay. I'm kind of excited about it, but kind of not, because it's going to be a lot of work. And then I opened up my big mouth. I said, oh, yeah, because we were talking about some of this. I said, oh, yeah. And then after that, we had the Alpha Jets or whatever. And then I said, oh, yeah, about those. So basically, when we're done with the Aleutian, the week after, we have the Alpha Jets. So I was like, it's going to be a busy month. So I may have a lot to talk about. I may not. Or I might be like, I'm tired. But we'll see. Another good thing is we were talking, and then my boss decided to go and said, oh, yeah, I need you guys to sign a waiver. So we're like, uh-oh, like, why do we need to sign a waiver? Well, apparently the Discovery Channel is going to be there for the Aleutian and making kind of like a documentary on it, or doing some kind of show or whatever, because it's going up to a mine up north, dropping equipment and stuff like that, so they might go up and down with them and whatever. So, but they want to see every aspect, so I might be on TV. You know, I don't know if they'll interview me or not, but you know, I might be on there doing my job, so that's kind of cool. So I don't know how I'll handle it. I seem to be a little bit camera shy. You know, I don't know if I can talk to cameras and stuff like that. And oh wait, I'll just pretend I'm talking to you guys. So you guys better watch the show if I'm on it. Yeah, that's right. But, yeah, so that's the scoop. Well, that'll be interesting. It's going to be busy. It's going to be crazy. at least I'll probably have more money because overtime and stuff. So we'll see what I'm in the mood or how much I'm in the mood today. I may go down to the downstairs to the workbench and show you what I got at Home Depot and how I'm planning on doing things for that booth. But, we'll see. We'll see. Like I said, I'm tired when I work 5 to 1. So I'll leave it at that, and I may see you at the workbench, or I might see you somewhere else. Yeah. Yay, Mario's interesting. Alright. Good day, everyone. It's Thursday. Yesterday, obviously, was Wednesday. I kind of felt like saying what was going on, but I just really wasn't in the mood. By the time I got home and everything, I was like exhausted. I actually went to bed at 8 o'clock last night, so, and I was still tired. But anyway, for those that are like following everything, we have that Aleutian coming in on Saturday. And we have two fuel trucks, so we're running two of them. And yesterday, I guess we had to empty the truck so we can get new decals, because anyway, new decals, stuff like that. Went to go empty the truck, and then the PTO shaft, which is the shaft that actually turns the pump so we can fuel, happened to, well, fall off, rip off, whatever you want to say, off the pump. So then it was like wobbling around from the other side, from the U-joint. So then that ripped a few airlines, and then it dented the crap out of our air tank and stuff like that. So now, well, obviously yesterday and today we're rushing trying to get everything like dealt with, because I mean, we'll be pumping 40,000 liters a day, you know, in that plane. So I mean, doing it with one truck kind of sucks, because one truck holds 18,000, the other 13. So I mean, while one's fueling, you know, the other one waits, then the other truck goes and fuels, the other one goes refills the truck, you know, stuff like that. So yeah, we're dealing with a lot. So I was like 2 hours late yesterday trying to deal with all this stuff. Like, I mean, not alone. I mean, I have coworkers, but I mean, you know, we're all trying to do everything we can to get this going smoothly and stuff like that. So that's what's going on. Today was kind of uneventful, busy. We're still dealing with trying to get stuff done. Although the airlines and the air tank should be changed today, and we're not sure about the pump yet, so that kind of sucks because we have to fuel them on Saturday. But we're hoping everyone's trying to rush everything, so everyone involved's really good. So I doubt any one of them follows me, but if anyone does or sees us at some point, thanks for doing your best and working hard and getting all this done, so you know, adds a little bit less stress on us. Now that that's done, I'm not as tired today, so I may go down to the bench and show you the stuff I got at Home Depot. And like, I'm not exactly sure how I'm gonna do things, because same thing, I went this week when I was tired and trying to figure things out and whatever, and just things aren't, you know, whatever. I'm gonna be like out of it for like a month because we're gonna be stupid, crazy busy. So go down there, show you what I got, try to figure things out, just stuff like that. And same thing, I have the weekend, well, I'm supposed to have the weekend off, but I'm going in Saturday. I was talking to my boss and he wanted to show up too on Saturday just to make sure everything works well. So I said, oh yeah, I'm probably gonna be there, because I said I want to put it on camera. He goes, oh, it'd probably be a good idea if you were there. So guess what? I'm working now. But I was talking to my coworker, and hopefully if all goes well, you guys are lucky. We're gonna have you, the GoPro, on whoever's going to be marshaling that aircraft in, will be wearing the GoPro on the chest. So we're gonna have get you guys are gonna get like first-hand view of the aircraft coming up towards you, and the other one will be will have my Sony camera and try to get that. So part of it will be on the vlog, probably on Sunday, all depending if I have time to edit everything out and stuff like that. And then like there'll probably be a whole separate video of the Aleutian throughout the weeks are, because I'm gonna want to get it landing, taking off, and whatever I can. So try to make one big video, or well, one video out of there that will be separate from the vlog as well. So that's the plan. Hopefully everything works and stuff like that. So bear with me. I'm tired and it's busy and stuff like that. So yeah, I've been mumbling for about 4 minutes now. So let's head down to the workbench. Why not try to figure out what I'm doing? Hey, it's just me trying to put it in the damn frame, and I keep pressing the record button. Hi. Bye. All right, so here we go. I don't know if you can see that. See? Look. I see what you see. But anyway, yeah, that way I can tell you guys are on my chest at the moment. I might bring you guys down a bit. Well, here's the bag of goodies. Receipt. Okay. Got me some nut and washers, because at some point I was thinking of maybe using this threaded rod for something, but I don't know if I'm using that anymore. And then here's the other stuff I got. Can you guys read that? There we go. So, you know, I'm thinking a whole bunch of stuff. This is the grill that actually goes on my or in my toaster oven. So I'm thinking I have like the wire, so I might just wired it on here, like on the, from the bottom when I'm doing stuff on the bottom. So I just wire it on like that. And thinking maybe same thing from the top, right? So same thing if I'm, I don't know if you guys can see that. Yes, you can, cool. I can wire that on to here. And then same thing, just wire the grate onto it or the grill. So bear with me again. I'm tired and stuff. So stuff like that. And I have a whole bunch of MDF and I in the garage for when I built my sub box. So I'm thinking build an MDF base for this and then put this on. And then, like I said, I can either build it up or do like that, but I'd rather metal and metal because that way I can just clip on that. But I'm not sure. You see, like at first my plan was to maybe put another plate, and then, you know, that was about the same size as this. And then what I could do is, you know, kind of weld that on to the steel plate. And then, you know, so too much stuff, I guess. I don't know. So I got some threaded rod for some stuff. So I was actually waiting. I use this. This works. I was actually waiting for you guys to open all this stuff up. So comes with the screws, and I'm going to probably use the MDF, and let's see how well this spins. Oh, that spins fairly well. So how about we do a test? How about I, let's see. Well, yeah, I don't have a base. So what I'll do is I'll try to put it up on here, wire it up first, and then show you guys, see what you guys think. And feel free, I mean, hell, I know right now I get like 30, 40 views, so who knows, but if anyone's out there and you guys have some suggestions on maybe how I can do this, or, you know, two heads are better than one and stuff like that, just let me know. So I'm going to try to just get that attached. And all right, well, I kind of did it kind of quickly or whatever. Still turns, not as smooth because the wire passes underneath here, so it kind of catches on it. So then who knows, maybe I can tack a little plate onto here and then literally just tack it on here and weld it. Because I mean, even if that's, if this is here, I mean, I can still go through here and still have all those if I really need to. So that might be my best option, maybe, just to, you know, I don't even need a plate at hell. I can just put it on here, just tack it just like that, tack it on, and then good. And then, you know, who knows, try to figure out another way to kind of put this on here. So that way I can just, you know, because I'd like to be able to remove this easily enough so I can just take it. Because if I have like multiple parts, it'd be nice just to take this out and then right into the oven. You know, if it's just one part, it's not too bad. Just unhook it, hook it to another one in the oven. But because, let's say, if the lug nuts, I got 20 of them, so I'd have to take 20 of them, be careful not to bang them. And then, yeah, not sure. But yeah, I don't like this wire setup. So I mean, it's sturdy. Well, it kind of works. Who knows, if I have some free time, I might want to just do this just to be able to do it, just to get powder coating done. Because then I can, well then, yeah, I was going to say, wire this onto there, but now I have like two wires and stuff like that, so that'll probably get stuck. So, and then, let's see, there's a, and then same thing, like I said, I can put that on a base. And then, you know, that'll spin. So, but this one's not too bad. Like for this, it's like something that just, you know, I can big part or bigger part that I can just put down and spin. So like that, I might just weld on or tack on a steel plate, and then just, I can just do it from there. Cause saying that's not too bad. Or no, cause then I need to use the stuff. Like I can't just, it's easier to take the whatever plate or this and then put it right in the oven. So those are my ideas. I'm not thinking straight. I'm tired and stuff like that. But so there we go. As I said, like just kind of brainstorming right now. I'm not really planning on doing anything real quick. At least I don't think so. I really don't know. But yeah. If you guys have suggestions, you know, whatever, give them to me. I'll take them in consideration. They might be better. Or I might just think about this stuff when I'm laying in bed and can't sleep or something. Because usually that's when we do all our thinking. Or, ooh, we're on the can. And maybe I'll just keep on fiddling around with this. But that's the idea. And hopefully at some point I can get some powder coating done. All right, here's what I'm thinking. It might work. but I kind of won't know until I test it out, I guess. Here's my idea. So I can probably, you know, tack that onto there, or I could have probably even maybe bolt it on. We'll see. But add onto that. I'm trying to make things as low cost as possible. All right, so I had this chain laying around, so then I had an idea. I have rivets. I'm gonna put this on here. You might guys might still be able to see it, but so if I rivet that like that, that goes through. It should be enough to hold the chain in, and then the other end here, just put an S hook, and then the S hook could go onto that. And then as I need to, I can just spin it as I go. So that might be an idea for the top. And then for the bottom, here's an old computer case. It's pretty decent thick steel, right? So I'm thinking, you know, I have enough. Oops. Well, I even have enough like that. But go like that, cut it out. They're the same size and whatever. And then I can tack that onto, like, the bottom one, like that. Who knows? I might just rivet those on just for now, just to see if that actually works. And then go from there. Hi, it's me again. I failed. Rivet works. I should have known. But it just spreads the chain, so it just falls off. So now I gotta cut that out. So my next thing is I'll probably just do like a small bolt and washer. Because I think I kind of like that chain idea. So I already looked. I don't have any bolts, washers, because that's why I went to the rivets, because I already had them. Check it out. I found two bolts, I guess, and nuts. So now it's bolted on, and so that's perfect. So now all I need to do is get the bolts, nuts, washers to attach to the chain, you know, go like that, and then say, and then I can just put the S hook wherever I want and stuff like that, and that should work perfect. So yeah, coffee time. Bye. Yay, good day. It's Friday afternoon, and ooh, pretty. Pretty disgusting. So anyway, the reason why I'm showing you this is, well, I haven't had any of this crap since I fixed that. So the plan is I'm gonna probably get so much vibration, but you guys are gonna go on there. More like wet, heavy snow, nothing really hard to really damage it. But anyway, I'll put you guys on there and we'll see how well the repair went. Right? All right. Yeah, good day. It's Saturday, and I said I had to work. Well, guess what? The aircraft got delayed again from Monday or Tuesday now. And who knows, it might be delayed again. So I'm back at the bench, and I went to Dad's Hardware. In other words, my dad. And he had a miscellaneous nut and bolt container, just like I do. And I found stuff to attach the chain. So we have that, and then I was thinking I needed to buy some S hooks. Well, guess what? You guys probably seen them before, but look up there. I have a whole bunch of metal hangers. So I said, well, why buy them when I can make them? So, got a little jig thing here. So we're gonna make our own. See? Finished product. Got my own S hook. So now I'm just gonna make three more for that application. There you go. Finished the other S hooks. Here it is kind of hooked up, and I think I can work with this. Because look, put my parts on. That spins relatively smoothly. So for the top part, I think I'm done. Now I just have to make the base for the bottom out of the MDF. I think I will cut out that steel plate, weld that on to the swivel, and then I can either put my grate on it or whatever. So yeah, that might be all the fiddling around I'm doing for today. I just want to kind of try it out. See you guys later. Hey, alright, well, I was just reviewing the footage of me making the S-hook, and my hand covered most of it, so I'm going to try this again and show you guys how I actually did the S-hook. I have a little jig set up. It was in between there, so I'll just go the other way and then... one side. This one's a little short, so anyway, you get the idea. It's because that's a little bit short for this circle. But yeah, so that's how I made my S hooks. And now I'm just having fun making a whole bunch of different size ones. So hey everyone. Well, it's Sunday at some point, but anyway, I'm fiddling around with the powder coating booth, and I see anything different. I had changed there before, and I was having problems, like, unhooking the grate, you know, with two hands, and then because I'd like to put everything on that grate and then be able to just lift the whole grate and put it in the oven instead of switching everything one by one. Well, I was having this problem. I told my wife and she came with a solution, because I had like these hooks which I was putting straight up there, you know, I still held it, but I wasn't able to spin it. All right, but then this is kind of a cool solution. I'll try to do it with one hand, but I'll be using two hands. But check this out. So I'm all done powder coating, you know, before it was, you know, because it's slightly heavy, but now I'm gonna try it. Not that my hands will be here anyway, but you'll get the idea. But as soon as I go like that, they all go in the middle and boom. So yeah, so I'd figured it out just to put it on here. That's what those markings are for. Then I couldn't spin it. So my wife said, well, just put that straight on there and whatever, and tried it, and I wanted it more on the outside so it's away from all the powder coated stuff, but you know what, I don't think it'll get in the way or anything, so there we go. So I'm hopefully going to powder coat next week, so that will be on next week's vlog. Cool. See you later. Good evening. It's Sunday evening. Time to close this vlog because there's nothing else going on. I'm going to finish this off with one more thing here at the bench, and well, it's... I did the base for the powder coating booth. So I thought I was gonna put a plate or whatever, but that works just like that. So I don't need a plate, don't need whatever. That base moves, it comes off, whatever. So that's it for the setup of the powder coating booth. So next week, I'm really hoping to get those lug nuts done and those brackets for the sub box. So that's it for this week. Thanks for watching, and we'll see you guys next week.